In the coast of West Africa, a city rises amidst lush mountains and the shimmery waters of the Atlantic. Freetown, the capital of Sierra Leone, is a city of resilience, a testament to the indomitable human spirit. But within its bustling streets, there's a story often overlooked, the story of the informal settlements that struggle against the very land they are built upon. Because we bump, not me say we for die. As climate change intensifies, these settlements are facing an increasing number of challenges caused by the lack of land use planning, housing and basic services that are exacerbated by climate impacts of flooding, landslide, heat stress, coastal erosion, sea level rise and water shortages, testing their resilience like never before.
Is a remarkable strength conceived in the spirit of this community. Imagine of community members working together, who have banded together and built a multi-level governance partnership to co-design nature-based resilience, basic services and infrastructure that ensure inclusive, equity and well-being for all residents to create a city that is not just sustainable, but thrives in the face of adversity.
Now, this ambitious journey was conceived in 2019, informed by Freetown City Council's Transform Freetown agenda, which triggered the birth of a consortium of international organizations with a common goal to create inclusive planning and nature-based solutions for resilience. This initiative evolved over time with the pertinent resourcefulness of Catholic Relief Services, thereby incorporating Fed-Up and Kodosapa and attracting Habitat, the Ministry of Lands, Housing and Country Planning, National Protected Area Authority.
It's about working with nature rather than against it. We are looking on how best we can integrate natural elements into our urban environment. It's not just about climate impact, but also to create a more livable city to all.
In addition to the centrality of nature-based solutions, is equally an important element of empowering the communities themselves, especially young people, as climate change action ambassadors, ensuring that they are not just recipients of change but active agents.
In order for us to achieve the Transform Your Life program objectives, we are working in collaboration with Kodosapa. And this collaboration, we are trying to produce a series of area action plans and we have forested the lost mangrove at the White Man's Bay and Cockle Bay. And in producing these plans, we are working with communities to develop resilience homes, and also we are trying to work with local partners or local authorities to create the sense of ownership are from the local level. And it's not about building homes, but it's also about creating a sense of ownership at the community level.
Now, the initiative didn't just aim at resilience. It was about transformation, about rewriting the narrative of these communities.
The impact has been transformative. We have seen reduced vulnerabilities to flooding and landslide. We have improved health outcomes and enhanced social cohesion.
The lessons from this transformative journey have become a beacon of learning, such that in 2024, the initiative is poised to dovetail into the World Bank's Resilient Urban Sierra Leone program, promising scalable transformation of lives and the restoration of hope for Freetown's 40% vulnerable population and those in other cities in the country and the global south.
Our journey is far from over. There are still challenges ahead, still miles to go. But we've laid the foundation, built a community, and that's a powerful thing.
And so, as the sun sets on the Atlantic, we are reminded of the resilience of Freetown, of the human spirit that refuses to be bowed. And we are reminded that with determination, with partnership, and with vision, we can build not just cities, but futures that are strong, sustainable, and inclusive, bearing in mind that the centrality of our nature-based solution includes the mangrove, the guardian of the coast.
Because we bump up, no me say we for die po. Because we no land book, no me say we for idle. Because we dead down now, no me say we no go.